stop. It runs east-west through Vancouver and is one of the city's main arteries.
At over $100 million, the Vancouver Art Gallery has a lot to offer. Their works include several native sculptures, as well as photography exhibits and artwork from a range of local and international artists.
The Armory is home to the Seaforth Highlanders, a reserve unit in the Canadian Army.
The public market is a one-stop shop for any fresh food needs.
Granville Street. During the 60s and 70s, the Granville area was the hub of counterculture. Many of the traces of Granville's groovier days are still present.
It's the First Baptist Church. In its short existence, this church saw several different locations and a major fire before it finally came to rest here in 1911. However, its trial by fire was not over. Another fire nearly gutted the building. But the faithful rallied again and it was rebuilt soon after. Today it stands with its counterpart across the street, St. Andrew's Wesley United Church, as a pleasant gateway marking the entrance to Vancouver's storied West End.
The West End is also home to Stanley Park, one of the world's largest urban parks. With the arrival of the railway came a new prosperity to the city, and the West End became known as the rich part of town.
And the mountains behind. There are also a wide variety of restaurants where you can soak in the scenery while dining on some of the best food in the city.
The rock structure coming up on the left is Inuit Inukshuk. Used by the Inuit peoples of the far north, the Inukshuk can serve many purposes. They have been used to herd caribou in specific places to make them easier to hunt. Often they are used as markers for travelers, indicating fresh water close by, or a particularly good fishing hole.
Park. Once we've entered the park, you'll see a statue of David Oppenheimer, Vancouver's second, and some say, greatest mayor. During his time as mayor, Oppenheimer worked tirelessly to turn Vancouver into a modern, respectable city.
Now we have all those things and more. Hey, son.
They're home here at some point during the year. The lagoon also has a nature house where you can learn all about the animals and plants we have here in Stanley Park.
At our next stop, you'll be a short walk away from the Vancouver Aquarium, Canada's largest aquarium. The Vancouver Aquarium is known not only for its superb exhibits, but also its ingenious idea of putting professional naturalists amongst the guests to see and interpret the animals' behavior for you. In addition to this, the aquarium also participates in an extensive marine mammal rescue program. Also at our next stop, you can go on a one-hour horse-drawn carriage tour of the park.
Destination for shooting since the 1930s. Productions of all sizes have been shot in and around the Vancouver area, making this city the third largest film production center in North America. It's estimated that over 200 film and television productions are shot here annually, injecting over $1 billion into our economy. You might see the large white trailers that are a sure sign of movie magic happening. Who knows? You might even spy your favorite celebrity.
again, still sleepy. Today is Saturday morning. 6:58, almost 7. We're ready for breakfast. We're still here in Vancouver. We're on the 8th floor. There's the view from the hotel. Here on Robson at Rosedale. Rosedale at Robson. Yesterday was a better view. We were on the 19th floor. Here, satellite gives us a set. Bathroom. Ian, smile. Ian. Close up, Ian. Close up. Today's the last day in Vancouver. We're going back to Seattle today.
Then work again.
Work. Can I go here?
My comics.
Okay. Sunset Beach. Strolling. Yeah? Friday on the beach.
Today is Saturday, August 30. We're here stuck with the big line going to US, back to US. We're at border, Canada-US border. Look. Look over there, that means look at the flags.
Yeah. And look at the line. Long line.
Big line.
Oh, pictorial pa sila doon. Kita niya, nagpipictorial.
Pictorial nga, isa.
Buti pa itong isa. Busy.
Nice flowers, oh. Saya din mo tayo.
Yum. Eat.
Good morning, everybody. How's your day?
Good. How about you? How's your day?
Good.
Okay. We're here in Seattle. We can't go to the science center. There's just too much going on. there near the Seattle Space Needle. So we're gonna check into the hotel and we'll see. Babu!
What? Louder like daddy. Babu!
Cerizal Bridge.
We already have
been here. Approaching right
first
turn.
Time.
South Charles Street.
This is my
second
time.
Remember when we went to the
This is my second time. Pacific Medical Center. And I remember just
ay hindi makita maaraw eh. Ayan, Dr. Cerizal.
Mami's not going down.
Dr. Cerizal Bridge.
Dr. Cerizal Bridge.
And that's the
left turn in point 4.
Don't look at my picture. My picture.
Left turn in point 4 miles.
Bakit pinangalan kaya ito?
How do I know?
Look at Ian. How he draw.
It's Spanish.
Good, look. That's frozen. Good job.
Alright. Frozen. Stay in this channel for 1 hour. Okay? This is not the channel.
And he's only 8 years old. Look at his idea. Wow, it's cool. What the day, man.
Friday was a scary day for people in western Cuba. Just south
good job.
Cuba, in Isle of Youth. A quarter of a million people were evacuated from its path here in western Cuba. And the winds were much stronger as the eye moved by than you're seeing here. Winds were estimated to be
main menu.
Cuba.
Next. User options.
They know what they're doing. They're keeping on a small
Mike.